It's time for another book review, but this time I'm purposefully wearing black because I am in mourning. One of my latest reads was Joan Didion's The Year of Magical Thinking. And listen, this one was a very sad story. I knew that going in. Back in 2003, her daughter was in the hospital on life support, and her and her husband came home from the hospital. He dies suddenly. I'll be honest, that what drew me to this book is that back in 2019, I dealt with a lot of death and loss in my own personal life. My grandpa died, my dad died, I put my dog to sleep, all within like a span of a couple months. So lately I've been drawn to books that talk about grief and loss in different ways, but this was not the one I needed. So first let's start with the title, which is also what drew me to the story, because I wanted to read about grief and loss, but I thought what a beautiful way to do it in a positive light with A Year of Magical Thinking. There's not a magical thought in this whole book. I literally flipped back through the book and I was like, let me find a magical thought. As someone who's known for not being super outwardly emotional, even I thought the book was emotionless and just cold. She doesn't make me feel any empathy for her, and I easily empathize with people. So here's the saddest part. The sentence that really solidified for me that I was not going to be able to connect with this book in any way or Joan Didion's perspective came on page 190. I want you guys to read it with me. I found earthquakes, even when I was in them, deeply satisfying, abruptly revealed evidence of the scheme in action. No, you didn't. Nobody finds earthquakes while you're in them deeply satisfying. No. That sentence summarizes how the whole book feels to me. Are you being completely honest with me? And are you being vulnerable? All right, but I'm gonna play devil's advocate to my own argument that the book is emotionless and not relatable. She tells a lot of parts where she's just disoriented and can't keep track of things. Maybe the book isn't meant to be a reflection on grief and loss. Maybe it is meant to make people feel how disoriented and lost and unconnected you feel to everything, even your own thoughts, your own self, and your own life. With that being said, I know that I posted this book on my Instagram stories, and so I felt obligated to tell you guys that if I went back in time, I would not read it. I don't think it would be helpful if you're grieving or lost someone, or if you wanted A Year of Magical Thinking.